Are we a state or are we a union territory?
Are we a state or are we a union territory? What is our identity? This is the question that Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal asked on the floor of the Delhi Legislative Assembly in April. And to discuss that issue, he has called a special 3-day session of the Delhi Assembly. So which one is it, state or UT? Well, the answer is a little bit complicated. Officially, it's still a union territory. In 1956, the States Reorganization Act created the Union Territory of Delhi. In 1991, its name changed to the National Capital Territory of Delhi. With a change in name came a change in status. It continues to be a union territory, but Delhi has started to resemble a state a lot more. It has its own Vidhan Sabha, its own High Court, and even its own executive branch. And yet, the Chief Minister of Delhi is often called a half CM. And for good reason. For starters, the Chief Minister is not the administrative head of the state. That role lies with the Lieutenant Governor. In other states, the Governor is just a nominal head, with the Chief Minister as the elected leader exercising the real power. But that is not the case with Delhi. Now let's come to the actual powers of the Chief Minister. The CM has control over health, education and transportation. So it's not like he has no powers. And yet, his hands are tied. There are three important subjects over which the Chief Minister has no power: land, police and public order. So if the Chief Minister needs land for a new project, he will have to run to the centre to get it approved. Even if the Chief Minister asks a police constable to do something, that constable will have the power to refuse the Chief Minister. But the Aam Aadmi Party government is pushing back and has taken this matter to court. The Aam Aadmi Party claims that the people of Delhi pay rupees 1.5 lakh crores in taxes every year, and they don't get their due when it comes to distribution of taxes among the states. Besides, Kejriwal has several times cited interference by the Modi government in their day-to-day functioning. But remember this, the power to create new states or to grant full statehood does not lie with state governments, but lies solely with the centre. So the question is not whether Arvind Kejriwal wants Delhi to be a full state. The question is, does the Prime Minister want Delhi to be a full state?